Hi, my name's Will, and I'm a graphic designer specializing in branding, hand lettering, and logo design. Today, we'll be focusing on two great design softwares for your creative projects and how you can use them together, Procreate and Vectornator. So why are these two a match made in heaven? Well, Procreate is an excellent pixel-based design tool and is a game changer when it comes to sketching out your ideas. It includes a sleek interface, 64-bit color, customizable brushes, incredible canvas resolutions, and a nice layer system and cinema-style effects. Speaking of brushes, you have more than 130 to choose from, and they allow you to use almost any art technique that you can imagine. Every brush is customizable and you can create your own as well. Plus, everything runs easy and smooth, just like you'd expect from an Apple product. Now onto Vectornator, another software designed specifically for Apple devices. It has a native Apple look and feel, which makes it easy to dive into and use straight away. Unlike Procreate, Vectornator is a vector-based tool, making it ideal to finalize any project started in Procreate. And it's also available on Mac, unlike Procreate. Some of you might prefer that when designing. But before we jump into some examples, let's look at the difference between pixel graphics and vectors. More precisely, we're talking about editability, quality, and even the size of your file. Vectors look sharp even when blown up in size, and they are endlessly editable with just a few clicks. You can see here how easy it is to change the shape of an object and how crisp it looks even at whatever zoom you're in. Vectors are the perfect vehicle for so many design projects. We'll cover only two today, but the only limit is your imagination. So how do these programs work together? Let's say you want to create a custom font. You can start sketching your characters in Procreate to define them individually, what the ascenders and the descenders look like, whether they have serifs or not, and so on. The great thing about Procreate is the freedom you have to sketch anything by hand. Now that you've achieved the shape that you want, import the file into Vectornator to turn it into a vector. While Vectornator does have an auto trace feature, I find it's better to use the pen tool or the pencil tool because they give you more control when designing. Same thing for the logo. Let's say you get a brilliant idea and you want to jot it down quickly. Use Procreate for that. Now that you've visualized your idea, you can materialize it in Vectornator. This is when you clean up all the messy lines. Boolean operations are a lifesaver, but the pen tool is also going to come in handy. I know you must have a ton of questions about how to actually do all these things, so be sure to tune into our next video, which will explain exactly how to turn your Procreate ideas into vectors in Vectornator. If you like this video, make sure to follow Vectornator on YouTube and Instagram so you don't miss a thing.